Hey, it's Glenn with the Cactus Atlas, and today we explore the Burro Schmidt Tunnel out in the middle of nowhere in the Mojave Desert. So the story today is about a gentleman, I'm not sure if he was an eccentric or what the deal was, named William Burro Schmidt. He moved out here from Providence, Rhode Island around the turn of the century because most of his family had tuberculosis and he was coming out here to escape it. The interesting thing is, this guy tunneled through almost all by hand this mine shaft that cuts clear through this mountain about a half mile long or something like that. Amazing. I had to come out here to see it, and boy is it remote. We'll talk about that in a moment. So he started construction of this thing in 1902, so this is well over 100 years ago. And we're really near that that tunnel. But first I wanted to check something out. His old house, his cabin, is right here. I think this used to be some kind of caretaker's cabin here, but if we can get in there, apparently he liked to post a lot of like newspapers and stuff all over the wall. So if I can get in there, we should be able to see some cool stuff. All right. You're gonna watch out for rusty nails too. Hope my tetanus shots are up to date. This is kind of freaky. All right, we made it. Oh, wow. Look. That's no lie. There is like stuff pinned to the wall all over the place. Holy moly, there's old newspapers. Let's take a closer look here. Can we see any dates on there? Look at that! Wednesday, October the 31st, Halloween of 1922. And up here, look, November 23rd, 1923. Okay, if the story about what this guy did isn't amazing enough, and we'll get into that more when we see the main attraction, this alone might be worth it. This is a time capsule in this thing. Wow! Probably not what I want to see. That looks like an old snake's carcass or something in here. Nice. Honestly though, that's worth the risk to me. This is amazing. Like, I've never seen anything like this. What I don't know is, why did he do this? Was it a practical reason? Was it like insulation of some sort? Was he just really that eccentric and kind of crazy? When you see what he did, I'm leaning towards that. But I have never seen anything like this. There's more newspapers up there too on the ceiling. Let's see if we can find more dates. I see November, but I don't see the year. Most of the newspapers seem to be from like the 1920s. I'm just gonna leave everything here though. I'm not gonna take anything or touch it in case future people want to enjoy this, but spectacular, absolutely spectacular. And these things are so old. You know, 1923, that's almost 100 years old newspaper. Can you believe that? This one here, let's look at this guy. What we got here? Again, that's that 1923. So yeah, it's the 1923 is the oldest date I've seen. I don't wanna touch this because it looks like it's just gonna fall apart. It's so old. Oh my God, what a find. Let's go check out this structure really quick and see what's in here. Okay, this is a little bit more safe. I love how I use the word safe in this context though. I don't know if there's anything safe about any of this. This part anyway, I think the tunnel's gonna be safe enough, but wow. I don't know how, I know nothing about this. The age or what this is. There's like an old bathroom in here. Wowzers. Hopefully there's no cuss words on the wall. Really not much of interest in here. Neat. Hey look, there's aliens. Here. We're not near Area 51 though. Wow. That was so cool. So, so cool. I loved that. I wish I could spend more time here. I'm on a time budget as usual, trying to get multiple videos done in a day. But I could spend a long time in there reading old newspapers and stuff. But now it's time to find the dang tunnel. I finally found something out here. I've been struggling all day long with some other things that I was looking for that I couldn't find. But this is pretty easy to find, relatively speaking. There are signs along the way that point you here, but make no mistake, this is extremely remote and it's miles of roads that I'm questioning if I should have done with a two-wheel drive, but I made it this far, so hopefully we're good. So here you go. Here's a quick monument outside the tunnel. It's a monument to William Henry Burrow Schmidt. So he took 38 years to hand dig this half mile long tunnel. It's like basically a mine, like kind of like a drift, and it goes clear on to the other side of the mountain. But yeah, this is something crazy cool, I think. Let's go explore this mine shaft. Before we do though, I want to say one more word about this. The guy that did this, like I said, this is about a half mile long tunnel. And I don't know why he did it. Maybe he was looking for metals at first, but maybe it just became a passion project. But he hand dug through this rock, like a half mile, almost all by hand. He did use some dynamite, but apparently he used a pickaxe and a hammer over the course of 38 years. And I heard a story that his abs were so ripped that he couldn't even stand up straight or something like that. And I believe it. So we're coming here to just see like one man's achievement, if you want to call it that, or maybe one man's eccentricity or insanity. I don't know. We'll decide later. But let's get on in this deep, dark tunnel. Let's hope there's no snakes in there. Ah, jeez. Wow, it smells like a freaking mine. What you would expect a mine to smell like. I can't describe it. It smells like railroad ties. That's the smell. Like the smell you smell next to a railroad. There's like an ore cart rail in here. And, oh, I can stand up a little bit. Here we go. Burrow Schmidt Tunnel. I'm scared. Woo! I'm 6'2". And so far, so good. This is awesome. This is one of the coolest things I've done. Has anybody seen, seldom seen Slim in here? Woo-hoo! Seldom seen Slim, are you here? This really scratches that itch for exploring an old mine, but I think in a somewhat safer way because they don't have this closed off, and I think it's a pretty well-known thing. This is awesome. There's an old ore cart track here that goes down this way. I've seen videos of this, so I think this is a dead end, but I think there's an old ore cart in here. This is awesome. Look at that. Heck yeah. That's not the ore cart. I don't know what this is. Somebody made a makeshift table back here, and it smells like urine. So I don't know if this is the public bathroom, but it's a dead end. Maybe Schmidt was originally following an ore vein or something. Who knows? Well, let's go back. Yeah, it's cool though. Now it feels like a real old mine. Here's the material. I don't know what that is. Is that quartz? I'm not a miner. I'm not a geologist. I don't know much about these things. Other than this is pretty cool. So I set up my own little like LED work lights to create my own little interior illumination here. So you can kind of see the tunnel a little bit better maybe. Let's turn off the lights and see what happens. Ready? Nervous, but... Can you see me at all? That way is pitch black. And let's see. Yeah, the camera can pick up the entrance, but this is weird. It's kind of freaky. Head towards the light. It's safe there. Come on, children, head towards... All right, I'm freaking myself out. Let me turn the light on. Oh my God. Why do I do that to myself? I had another vision of Reverend Kane from Poltergeist, the old creepy man. I was talking about him in a different video when I was at a pioneer cemetery. And now I can't get the image out of my head. And this is not the place where one should be thinking of things like that. If there is a catastrophic failure of all of my lighting equipment in here, you could get out of here alive, because there's really only one way. You would probably just have to go very slowly and feel the wall and go in either direction, and you should be okay. I'm gonna try something though here too. I actually brought matches, so I wanna light a match in here and see what this looks like by match light. Hopefully there's no flammable gases in here. I don't think there are, I think we're safe. All right, hold on a sec. Oh my God. Holy moly, I can't see but 2 feet in front of me. But if I had to navigate out of here with just matches, I think I could do it. I do. Is there gold in these mines? Is there gold in here? I don't know. Oh my gosh. Y'all can have your Big Thunder Mountain any old day of the week. I have now gotten a taste of what it's like to explore like a hard rock mine, and I am hooked. This is the wildest ride in the wilderness. Yeah. Hi ho, hi ho, hi ho. It's through the Burro Schmidt tunnel we go. All right, what's going on here? We came to a decision point. Ah, I see daylight. It's the other end. We made it, I think. But there's another way to explore. So let's go this way. Show you how short this is. Ah, my neck's gonna hurt after this, no doubt. So we made it to this end. Does it keep going? It does. What's down here? Mr. Schmidt, what kind of craziness did you conceive here, my friend? Look, there's like old trash and stuff. Oh, there's a dead end. I think we made it to the end. I've seen other videos, so I already know. This is getting really short. I guess Mr. Schmidt didn't want to invest the time into making this tunnel a little more easy for guys like me. There we go. I officially made it to the end of this side. So, the completionist in me is satisfied. All I found down there was rat poo and a dead end and some beer cans. Wow, this side's short too, but we are heading towards the light. So I've hit my head now a good 3 times. So anybody that laughed at me in the beginning of the video for putting a helmet on, I'm totally justified. We have made it to the other end exactly when my battery is about to die. Let's see if we can make it through and out to the sunlight before the battery dies. Woohoo! Come on. Let's do it, baby. Oh, yes. Look at that view. Ah, Mr. Schmidt. You wise old devil, you. Let's take a nice long look at the Mojave Desert, folks. You can see probably for hundreds of miles here. Barstow, California, by the way, is somewhere out that ways. That's where I came from. That's where I'm spending the night. Let's go hike over here for a second. So some interesting things about Mr. Schmidt. He was asked, why did he do this? And he claimed it was to make a beeline towards an ore smelter, but clearly this just came out here. There's not gonna be any ore smelter over here. So why did he do this? Nobody's ever really gonna know. I think something about the Mojave Desert brings out the crazy in people. I think I see someone else coming too. Hello everyone.
How you doing?
Good, how are you guys doing?
Not bad.
Good. It's awesome.
Come on, little one.
Hey.
Yeah, now I can.
Look at this explorer here. Hey, how's it going? Why the heck did William Burrow Schmidt dig this? That's the next mystery we have to uncover on this channel. Maybe underneath all that newspaper in his cabin under a wall somewhere is an explanation. I see daylight on the other side. Oh, I think we're gonna make it. But yeah, you come with a large group. It's very dusty. There's probably about 20 people that I just passed, big family. Somebody even brought their small dog, as you saw in here, so I guess it's pet friendly. We survived the Burrow Schmidt Tunnel. Yeah, that was awesome. To me, the best part about that was if you want to experience what it's like going through a hard rock mine, like a real mine, that's gonna give you that experience without the fear of falling down like a stope or breathing in bad air or anything like that. So that's mainly why I chose to do it, is I wanted to get that experience under my belt, see what it was like without all the worry. Although I do have to admit, you know, halfway through you gotta think, what if there's an earthquake or what if there's a cave-in or whatever? But that thing's been around since, you know, he finished it in the 30s, so a lot of it might even be over almost 100 years old or older now, and it's still there. And I didn't see any evidence of cave-ins or anything, so I'd say it's safe. The dangerous part, though, is getting here, I would say. That's the part I'm iffy about. I don't know what to recommend. Here's the car that I did it in. It's a rental car. It's a Chevy Trax, and you could see the clearance. I mean, it had enough clearance to not scrape the bottom. I didn't have any issues, but I still have to get out of here now. That's the only other catch, but this vehicle did it. It's two-wheel drive. It does not have four-wheel drive. So hopefully I get out. If I don't, I'll update the video, but this proves that you can do it in two-wheel drive. So if you enjoyed this adventure, because I know you did, please subscribe to our channel, because I do this stuff all the time and we've been going at it now for a couple years and there's no sign of stopping. We release weekly and I am always trying to get out all over the place in the Southwest to keep you entertained. So hit that subscribe button. Thanks.